It's the Rumor Report.
The Breakfast Club.
Well, looks like there is going to be a Coming to America sequel. Eddie Murphy did confirm on Friday that it's happening. He said, after many years of anticipation, I'm thrilled that Coming to America 2 is officially moving forward. We've assembled a great team that will be led by Craig Brewer, who just did an amazing job on Dolemite. And I'm looking forward to bringing all these classic and beloved characters back to the big screen. So he is going to do his role as African Prince Akeem. He went to Queens 3 decades ago. He was looking for his queen, as you all know. In the sequel, he's going to be looking for his son. Now, Blackish creator Kenya Barris is the person who is actually writing the script as well.
That's what I heard. I heard that he had an illegitimate child 30 years ago when he came. Well, not illegitimate because he wasn't married, but when he was out here doing his little dating thing, he shot somebody club up, and now he got a son out here, and now the son is coming back to Zamunda.
I'm excited about that. That's my favorite movie of all time, and I'm excited about
it. I like it because, you know, now these kids will know what I'm talking about when I ask them, would you rather be in Wakanda or Zamunda? Because that's really a question you can only ask somebody 40 and up. Because only we understand that.
Another great part of that movie was the scoring of it and the music that was in it.
Oh, yes.
Shout out to Nile Rodgers. So I hope they bring him back because he scored the original as well.
But question, where would y'all rather live, Wakanda or Zamunda?
I don't know what Zamunda really looked like.
But see, I look at Wakanda as New York. Like, you'd work in Wakanda, but Zamunda would be Jersey. So you live in Jersey. You know what I'm saying?
I kind of like Zamunda.
All right. Yeah. Well, congratulations to Master P. He tweeted out, today we made history, signed one of the biggest deals with Lionsgate for the Master P biopic, King of the South, Ice Cream Man. Here's what he had to say.
Today is a big day for us, man. God is good. Just signed the biggest deal. Look all this work, man. It took like a year. King of the South coming down to Lionsgate. Biggest deal. A hip-hop artist still alive. Being able to be thought. Straight Outta Compton was big, man. This is about to be one of the biggest movies next year.
Well, finally, dropping the clues bombs for that.
Yeah, that's great.
Okay. He also shouted out Lil J, Uncle Luke, and Tony Draper, the kings he said that came before him. Tiger Williams wrote the script, who did Menace to Society. So there you go.
I'm in that movie.
All right. You're the uncle, right? Or something like that?
I'm the guy who finds Master P after he gets shot.
All right, now Aquaman has made $1 billion. They're making box office history with that. It's the first DC Comics film to surpass over $1 billion since The Dark Knight Rises. That was back in 2012, and they said it's on track to be the top grossing movie in DC history. Did you guys see that?
No. As a Marvel head, you know, it's just very hard for me to go spend my hard-earned money on DC movies. Okay, but I may or may not go see Aquaman. I'm not sure yet.
All right, and Kevin Hart's movie, The Upside, actually beat Aquaman. That Upside is the number one movie. Aquaman, I guess, has been number one for like the past, 3 weeks? So now The Upside has unseated that number one spot. So congratulations. Kevin Hart is going to be with us today, and he stars in The Upside also alongside Bryan Cranston. Nicole Kidman's in the movie. I saw it. It was a great movie. So you guys have a chance to see that. It made over almost $20 million over the weekend.
We're dropping the clues bombs with Kevin Hart. He'll be here in 5 minutes.
Yeah, less than five minutes.
Mm-hmm. And just so y'all know, everybody that is using someone else's Netflix account, that might all come to an end. They have a new software that they're doing for all these streaming services to make sure that you can't share your account with non-paying friends. So you have to get one of those premium accounts to be able to share your account with other people.
That's whack. That's part of the Netflix experience.
Nearly 26% of millennials share their Netflix credentials. So I guess they're losing money.
That's what you do with your friends. That's how you know you got real friends.
Shout out to Janae.
Well, that's real friends.
And my brother.
Let their friends hold their Netflix password.
All right, and get ready for the Super Bowl halftime show. See if you're interested. You know Maroon 5 is already the ones that are headlining, but they have confirmed they'll be joined by Travis Scott and Big Boi for the halftime. So now Travis Scott is requiring that the NFL actually donate to a social justice cause. They're going to be donating to Dream Corps, and that nonprofit is a social justice accelerator, which backs initiatives that close prison doors and open doors of opportunity for all. Part of what he is requiring.
Big Boi from Outkast?
Yes.
Okay, I can see Big Boi wearing a Colin Kaepernick jersey, taking a knee on the stage. Mm-hmm. I can see Big Boi making a stand in some way.
All right, well, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your Rumor Report.